Hey guys, so we're back. I am going to replace the flyback. So I started out by replacing, in the last video, I started out by replacing the capacitors. So we did primarily a cap kit on the entire board and the B plus filter cap. So that went really well. One thing I forgot to do was trim the leads. I'll show you guys that. We'll zoom in just so you can see exactly what you're looking for when you're trimming leads. And then right now we're going to replace the flyback, and then we're going to replace the hot. Now the flyback I have is right here, and I found my thermal grease for the hot, by the way. The flyback I have is right here. So this is an aftermarket flyback. It is not OEM in any way. And so I had to do a little research on these flybacks, because it's not the same as the one that's installed there. The one that's installed, it's got some mounting screws on it that you mount some other parts to. We won't be using that. We're just going to kind of make it work. But the reason we're not using an OEM part is because they don't make OEM flybacks for the Sanyo 20EZs anymore. You got to remember, these things were made in the early 80s. So, you know, they're 30 plus years old. So those parts are available. So we got this flyback from arcadepartsandrepair.com. I don't know why I ordered it from there. I think I was probably looking on Clav. And it was mentioned on there, and I usually go with Clav if they say, you know, use this part. I go with it, because those guys know what they're doing. Oh, I didn't turn on my light. Well, we'll do that later. So anyways, let's get to replacing the flyback and replacing the hot. We're gonna start with the flyback. You'll see what I have to do to get that off. We've got to pull the solder off of you know, all the little pins on the flyback. We'll show you that, and then the hot needs to be replaced because that typically goes with the flyback. So I'm going to cut to that.
All right, guys, here we've got our board. First thing I'm going to do is trim the leads, because we didn't do that in the last video. We completely forgot to do that. I was exhausted. I was very tired. So we're going to trim all these leads off here, because you don't want these poking out. We're going to watch that little wire. You know, whatever the factory mod is on that, or whatever the reason for that wire is there, we're not going to cut that, because that would be bad. But all these little leads, we're going to cut all these off, because we saw in the last video we got everything installed properly. So we don't need these leads anymore. Now they're just kind of getting in our way, making the rest of the repairs more difficult. So let's just get in here and start trimming. Okay, so there's one, there's two. Let me give you, let's maybe zoom in a little bit here. You can see those are the ones I just cut. Well, let's, oop. Well, that was a pretty drastic jump there, wasn't it? Let's do those. Oop, wrong way. Can we get it? You want to zoom? Wanna focus? Come on, buddy. No? Goofy little camera doesn't want to focus. Focus. Okay. We are definitely not going to focus on that. Oh, we had it. There it goes. Okay. There's our lead with our wire, and we need to be really careful on trimming this one, so we don't trim our wire off. And we're just going to cut a little bit above where the solder was. You don't want to clip into your solder, because that could affect it. You know how currency flows. So there, you can see I just clipped them off there. That looks pretty good. That little mod is still pretty intact. All right, let's back up. Oh, not forward. Back.
Let's do one more. Let's see. You guys can see that one. Let's clip that guy. Maybe even clip that guy. How about that guy? Let's clip that guy. I'll try to get my hand out of the way there so you can see it. I like trying to grab the lead. There you go. You can still see that. There you go. That's all we're doing. Just cutting leads off. Nothing exciting. It's just the kind of the end of the cap kit that we did in the first video. That we didn't finish. So we'll just we'll finish it now. Oop. And you just, you know, after you're done clipping these, and as you're clipping them, you just kind of want to make sure that you're getting these leads off the board. The last thing you want to do after a cap kit, and I can tell you from experience, because I've lost a lead and couldn't find it, and then later found it as it shorted out another capacitor in the system. The last thing you want to do is leave a lead on the board, or a piece of the lead where it can short something out, because you'll be sad if that happens after you've done all this work, you know, gotten all these capacitors in there, made it all nice and pretty, and then did something stupid like left the lead too long, or, you know, left a piece of it on the board where it could come in contact with something else. Okay. And some of these leads are, like, from the factory, just really long. Like, they didn't cut them very short. They cut them, they cut them pretty high. So, or whoever was in here working on it before me, left them pretty high. Whatever they were doing to this poor machine. And hopefully, after we're done with this flyback replacement and the hot replacement, and we find a machine that we can throw it in. I mean, I could probably throw it in the other machine, but I got to get a power supply for that other machine. I don't want to power that machine up the way it is. It's just in really bad shape, so we're gonna get a power supply for that one. We need one for it anyway. I am gonna restore that other machine. I was talking to some guys on Clav over the weekend, past few days here, and I found out the original machine is I can't pronounce it, but it's supposed to be Tutankhamun, you know, the Egyptian pharaoh Tutankhamun, the King Tut, but they misspelled it apparently. Or they couldn't pronounce it or something. So it's like Tukumin, or I can't pronounce it. Game I've never played, but it is original. That's what was originally in that cabinet that Double Dragon is currently in. So we're pulling all the Double Dragon stuff out. We're gonna try to hunt up Double Dragon cabinet, you know, and maybe we'll just, you know, we can always just hold on to that Double Dragon board and throw it in another machine, you know, a Double Dragon if I find one down the road. It's definitely not something I'm going to get rid of, because I loved Double Dragon when I was a kid. I played it all the time on the Nintendo. I played a lot in the arcade. You know, some people really like Double Dragon 2. I think Double Dragon 2 is trash. Double Dragon 1 for life. Okay. I think that's all the leads. I'm not getting poked by anything. Some of these leads are really long, but that's okay. We're going to leave them that way. It's not a big deal. Okay, so now what we need to do is get to the flyback, which is up in this corner here. Let's see if we can... Let's see if we can zoom in on that. Let's move the board around here. Oh, we're gonna zoom. Oh, we're thinking about it. Okay. Well, we won't zoom. That's fine. We'll consider that zoomed. Okay, so here's our flyback solder points. And you can see some of these are really ugly. Really, really ugly. They look cooked. So we're going to get in there and we're gonna pop these off. And this is kind of our starting point for our flyback. And I mean, the solder comes off really easily. So maybe the solder's not that old. But I can't imagine this is an original, or I can't imagine this was replaced. Just because it's in really bad shape. Well, that's a lot of solder coming off there. Look at that. We're leaving solder on the board. Can't do that. Whoa. We're getting this little, my little cheapo desoldering tool is starting to get a little full, it looks like. And I cleaned it out a little bit. Maybe not enough. You know, and these aren't, these aren't anything. I mean, this thing was like $15 or $12 or something like that. It was cheap. You know, it has its limitations. When you start pulling off a lot of solder, I cleaned it out a little bit, but I mean, you can tell there's still a bunch in there. So it's not like a Hacko where, gotta be really nice to have a Hacko. Those things are just, I watch, John from John's Arcade do his videos with the Hackos, and it's just, you get such envy from watching him. He's just like, do-do-do-do-do, just pulling out solder everywhere. Tons of solder on this thing. So yeah, Hacko would be sweet, but this is what we got. $15. Gets the job done. Could always use a solder pullet too. I like this a little bit better. It's integrated, but I gotta hunt up some replacement tips. If anybody uses one of these goofy little solder pulling soldering irons and you know where you can get the tips, let me know. I haven't researched it a ton, but it'd be a good thing to have new tips. I know I was reading on Clove that there are different there are replacement tips that you can get, so I know they're out there. I'm just kind of going to go over everything here and just give it a once over. Doesn't look like anything's lifted. Looks okay. All right, let's take a look and see. What we're going to do is we're going to pull out the old flyback. We're going to take that cover off. You can't see that because we're zoomed in, but here. There you go. We're going to pull out the newest flyback, and this thing cannot zoom that quickly. It's getting angry with me. Yeah, all right. Let's not bother with that. But anyways, I'm just looking at the old flyback, comparing it with the new flyback, and making sure I didn't miss any solder points, and I did not. Okay. So some more leads. Let's zoom out here. You can see what we got going. Okay. Let's see where we're at here with Senor Flyback. Okay, it feels loose on the board. There are a couple screws holding it in. So let's get those screws out of there. One thing I noticed is that I don't have case screws for the inverter board cage mounts. You know, it mounts on top of that, and I don't have case screws for that. I don't have these little screws that go on the side. So I got to try to hunt some of those up. If anybody has any ideas, I'm sure I can just run to Home Depot and find something that'll work. Okay. That's our little control board there. And there's our flyback. Wow, that came off really easily. Oh, geez, people make a big deal out of it. Like, that's really, this was the first flyback I've ever done. That was really easy. I mean, I don't know. I don't think that was complicated. Well, let's see what happens when I actually put the flyback on. Okay, and then this has to come off. Let's get that back up there. That piece goes to the wiring harness. So this, oh, wow, okay. Okay, that comes off. And that goes in. So that must be our red wire coming out the top there. Yeah, it is. Because I was looking at the videos. Or the, another poster on Klopp's pictures of a replacement he did. So I just need to look and see where these black wires are going to go comparatively to the replacement. Okay, so should look like that. All right, so the black wire, we got one black wire here and a red one on you. So black here, red on you. Okay, let's grab some markers. Let's grab some markers here and let's mark this up so we know what we're doing. On these pins, can I mount them? No, I don't suppose I could. Okay, so black is up here. Let's get that, you know what? Let's just make sure we get that all the way around. We'll get a little excited with the marker, but better safe than sorry, right? And then we'll call red is green. So red is definitely Christmas. Okay. And that'll be this guy down here. That's you. Okay. All right, let's get rid of that styrofoam. Let's take our thermal paste off the box because we're not going to need that box anymore. Okay, so let's take new flyback and put her over the side and take old flyback and get some of that old and some of this old solder off. Actually feels like it's coming off. Nope, that's not. All right, we didn't get the other soldering iron started up. Well, let's do that since we're sitting here. Okay. Come on up, baby. Come on up. You don't want to work with this tool, do you? Nope, I wouldn't either. Okay, that didn't work. We need the real soldering iron for that. The real soldering iron. I don't want to clip those leads. I mean, I suppose I could. You know what? Why are we making our life so hard?
Let's not. There we go. Much easier. Okay. Old flyback. She dead. Look at that. You know, look at that nice little burn mark in there. See that? That's bad. You can see it. It's really bad. I don't know if that's just a crack. It's just, you know, it getting old. Again, 115 volts. But it ain't going to work. One thing we do need to do is we've got to pull our old pin off here. It looks like that was soldered on also. So our old pin, let's see. That pin that we pulled off, we need to use that still. So I'm just going to try to bend it here with my foot. My pliers that aren't here. You know, sometimes I just wonder what I do with all my toys. Oh, there it is. We'll use our little wire clipper here. It shouldn't clip it. Well, now I don't trust it. Sure, be a lot easier if I had my needle nose instead of using my fingernail. I don't need my needle nose put back on anyway. You had enough yet? Oh yeah, you are. I don't think it would be. Okay. Too hot. That is too hot. Like one strand of wire holding it on. Come on, one strand of wire. Just break. Beautiful. Okay, so that comes off there. And it goes on the new one. And let's get our little boot too so we can make this professional looking. Get a little boot on there, right? And get a little wire through there. And we're just gonna take our wire and kind of fold it over. See that? Pretty exciting stuff. Let's take that wire and kind of fold it over. And we're just gonna hit it with a little dab of solder. Geez, I didn't even have my solder out. I thought I'd at least pull that out. Apparently not. Man, I came ill prepared for filming. Put you over there. Okay. Okay, that looks pretty good. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that wire's going nowhere exciting. Boot should fit over. All right, we need to go find our pliers quick. So hold on for 1 second, boys. bit, gents. I said, doy. So it's sitting right next to me.
Beautiful. This is... Oh. I try to do anything with the wrong hand. Look at that. Huh? Huh? It's like professional. Got our boot on there. Huh? Boot. Oh, look at it. It's on there. Okay. Boots on. The bad boy looks good to go. Okay, we still got our ink on our leads so we can wire up the new leads. Let's just take a little bit of wire off both of these. Whoop, he didn't come off. There we go. Okay. The other one had it kind of towards the bottom. Which. Let's, I think I can do that. Maybe like that. Stick some lead in my mouth. It's not a lot of lead. It's just a little lead. It's gonna hurt me. Well, not right now. Boy, lead's just fighting with me tonight, aren't you? You don't want to see in your little pocket anymore. It's about time I get some new lead. This lead is... Oh, this lead is done. Let's just tin it. Tin it somewhere in there. Looks good. Let's drop our wire down. Boy. Oh no, I pulled too hard. I had it like set perfectly too. That's too high. Ugh. Oh, solder. Why do you have to fight with me? I need both hands. I'm gonna need them. Just give them to me. There we go. Okay, let's try this again. There we go. Much better. Okay, and I think I saw online, one of the guys online just kind of took the wire and there's a little notch right here. He's kind of poked out a little notch, like an X-Acto or something, for the wire to slide through. And that should work. I don't see why not. It goes in like that. And it's got to come back over here. Like up there. Well, maybe I should just run myself a new chunk of wire. Looks like... Oh, it's solid, though. I don't know if I have any solid. Well, let's see if we can make it work. I really don't think I have any solid core wear, so I don't think I can even just run, you know, a new piece of, I don't know, 22 gauge maybe. Oh, actually, I think the guy online, I was looking, you know what, why don't I quit calling the guy? Let me pull up Clav here so I can actually give the guy credit, because his mod was the way to do it. Yeah, he took the leads off the bottom. He took the leads off the bottom and ran one to this purple, that's F8, and he ran the other to this red right here, which is AO, and I think that's what I'm going to do. Yeah, we're going to do that. Wait, before I keep calling him that guy, that was Jeff F. from Johnson City, New York. So thank you, Jeff F., for a little help on your mod here. I appreciate that little chunk of knowledge. You just saved me wasting a lot of time trying to put this on. So I can just pull this solder off, which is exactly what I'm gonna do. We'll pull this. Oop. Let's see if we can. It's pretty down there, pretty deep. Oh yeah, baby, came right off. Okay. All right, so we'll do you in a sec. Let's get you out of the way. Let's just try shoving our Oh, maybe I should do that first. It looks like there's a little notch here for where the flyback goes around the Oh, I see what he was saying. He had to break that off to get this to mount properly. Yeah, I totally see what he was saying. Yeah, because it doesn't sit far back enough. Okay, so this, where is it? This little tab right here, it's preventing me from mounting this correctly because it's hitting the AO pin right here on the board. So I'm just going to clip that off. I'm going to clip that little bad boy off because I don't need it. It's not doing me any good. It's gone. Yeah, I was confused about what he was doing there. He was talking about that. Oh yeah, I see AO on the board. Bottom of the board goes right to that little wire there. Did he solder that? Or did he just wrap it around like they do on some of these wires? Jeff F. from Johnson City, New York. Did you solder that onto the board? I can't tell. It doesn't look like it. It looks like you just wrapped the wire around. I'm soldering it. I wonder if I should do that first. Yeah, I'm gonna do that first. I am. As you can see, guys, I am definitely not a professional. You know, some of this stuff, this is... well, I mean, a majority of this stuff, this is my first time doing it. So, I mean, I'm just going through Clav posts. I'm just, you know, watching videos. John's Arcade, I've watched a ton of his videos. It's been very helpful. You know, I'm watching videos and reading Clove and trying to get this machine that I don't really even have a board for to work. And we'll throw it in Double Dragon. That's what we're gonna do. We're gonna throw in Double Dragon. I'm just gonna get a new power supply. I got a power supply coming for the monitor. I don't know if I told you guys that. There was a user on Clove that had an extra Nintendo transformer. So I'm gonna wire that in there. Just so I know I'm getting the correct voltage. You know, I had some people online tell me, oh, you're fine, you can use a 115, whatever, it'll work fine. I'm like, nah. A lot of people are saying it won't, so I'm not gonna do that. Should we get some flux? We should get some flux. There she goes. We're gonna flux the other one. That one, not really excited about going on that pin. It went on there, but I was kind of reluctant on it. I think we'll have better luck with this one because we'll use our magical flux pen. And get a little flux on that bad boy. Get a little flux on there. Don't pull the whole damn flux pen out. There. That'll get the solder to stay a little bit better. That was probably really loud. Sorry about that, guys. Where'd our terrible solder go? Alright, you guys. There it is. You're supposed to tell me where the solder was, but I didn't need you after all. Good. That's very good. Jeff F. from, where is it, Columbus City? Somewhere like that? Johnson City. You know, it was President City. Thanks, Jeff F. Saved us some headaches. I mean, I get where people's frustration comes from doing flybacks because this, you know, getting all the holes in there, that's kind of a headache. But, I mean, you're just going to fall out, aren't you? Are you resting on it? There we go. Sorry, guys. I do want to get that nice and flush, so let's just maybe grab our flux pen again. We're just gonna hit a couple of these main ones. It's a lot of flux. There we go. Now we're calming down a little bit. Okay. Looks good. And we're going to hit a couple of the main ones first. We're just going to get a little solder on here. Come through. I'll get you in there. Am I going to keep you there? Yeah, that's keeping you there. Okay. How secure are you? Oh, you're tight. Yeah, and they're nice and tight.
Okay. Run out of solder. Wow, it's the end of an era. I need new solder. I've had this stuff forever. I think this is the stuff I used on my first like Nintendo console. My first mod. Installing a mod chip in an NES, or not an NES, PlayStation 1. Those look pretty good. Those look pretty darn good. Yeah, man. I think she's solid. Let's take her clip and put you back on. I suppose let's push that back a little bit. I can. And then a guy was taken. Is that electrical tape? No. Okay, no, it's not. It's just somebody keeping the wires bound together with electrical tape. Which, I mean, I guess if you don't have any zip ties handy, it'll work. Okay, and then he was, Jeff F was just kind of poking it through the clip to hold it in place. I'm going to go look at that again. See how he did it there. Oh, he zip tied it. Oh, I get it. He zip tied it right to it. Do we need to zip tie it? I mean, is it going to come off? No, it's like, it's fine. Jeff F, I'm not zip tied now. I'm not taking your advice there. You're losing that battle. But otherwise, I really appreciate that little mod you gave me there. That looks good. Everything on there looks solid. She ain't going nowhere. Okay. Let's just get some of these wires. I mean, that's it? That's a flyback? People freak out about that? I mean, is the 20EZ like an exceptionally easy flyback replacement or what? That didn't seem bad to me at all. Maybe I'm just and watch when I plug this thing in, the flyback explodes. Whoops. Okay. So I suppose now we're gonna move on to the hot, which is right there. It's a new one.
is a new one for me. I've never replaced a high output transformer before. Got your little plastic insulator deal. I can't remember what the hell they call that. The plastic insulator deal. Let's see. That's too big. He's too big. Will not work. There we go. Oh, look at that. We got bolts on the back side of this. Or nuts, rather. Grab that. Let's grab one of our plastic dealies. Plastic dealie. Let's grab some of this there non-conductive thermal grease. The non-conductive thermal grease and the flyback I got from that arcadepartsandrepair.com. I think the flyback was $25. Thermal grease was, I don't know, 50 cents, not even that. It was whatever. And then a little plastic thing. Got that. Hold on for 1 second. Okay, so we got our little goofy plastic thing and our gotta close that door. And our hot, which is here. And we got two of them. Just in case we muffed it, which is entirely possible. These things are really, really packed in. I think I got the hots from Ian Kellogg. I'm pretty sure I did, actually. IanKellogg.com. That's kind of the place to get your stuff. Cap kits are awesome. You hear that, Ian? If you're watching this. Showing you out. Okay, so I don't know if you hear. Let's take this off. I don't know if you can see it or not, but one side, I don't know, can you see that? One side longer than the other. And you can, I mean, you can just look at it on your old one. You'll kind of see, you'll see that it's same way. Okay, we gotta pull that we gotta pull the solder off it first. Let's turn the board here so you can see. You can see what I'm doing. Maybe. Oop, wrong way. Whoa god, this thing just jumps. I don't know. I don't know if we'll get very good video of that. Might be hard to do like this. Well, let's try it. Take our red wire and just get you out of the way. Okay, got you out of the way. You know what, let's use the, let's get these wires out of this little harness first, just to make it easier to pull them. Okay, there's that, and there's that. Now let's try doing the yellow one first. We're gonna come under,
That's power cord. Let's get the power cord out of the way. Got a bunch of stuff going on here. Power cord just kind of wrapped around stuff. Okay, there we go. There we go. Now we can get to you easily. Let's see if we can get you off. Yep. There's the old wire. Okay, yellow was on left, black was on right. Let's remember that. And new wire. Or black wire. New wire. Well, that wasn't that hard. They both popped right off. Ow! Why would I grab that? That was so dumb. Let's grab a wire we just unsoldered. Okay. Back to it. Oh, man. Sometimes you really gotta question the things you do. I mean, maybe not you. Maybe it's just me. It's entirely... You know what? Why don't I put these in my little dish before I lose them? Because I will absolutely lose those. There we go. Okay. There's our two sets. You're gonna pull right out. Okay. They install a little insulator in here. I don't think we've ever seen that. There is, there's a little insulator on this. I mean, not like I have a ton of experience with this, but all the videos I've watched, I've never seen one of those. Okay, so we're just gonna match it up here. Let's go like that. Yeah, it goes like that. Yep, it absolutely goes like that. Okay, so it goes in just like that. So let's get our little tube of goop. A little tube of goop that looks like it's going to be able to be cut, but it's a liar. And this has to be non-conductive grease, by the way. You know, don't throw any Arctic Silver 5 or I don't even know what they use anymore on the console games or the the PC, you know, PC CPUs for grease. I bought like Arctic Silver was on sale years and years and years ago for like $3 a tube, and at that time we're just gonna wipe in our pants. At that time, bought like 50 of them. I just went ham. So I've been using the same stuff for years. And it's not like rotting out or anything. It still works fine. Okay, got our thermal grease in there. Okay, there we go. That looks good. Looks good, except we dropped our little plastic thing that's supposed to insulate it. Now, this needs to be insulated. That's what that little plastic deal is for. That's why I got them, because you can't have metal to metal here. It has to be insulated. So even your little pins that go through here, you cannot let them hit the can't let them hit the sides, so you just gotta kind of look, and they're not going to. These are the pins I'm talking about. by the way. So now we're just gonna screw her all back together. Okay, that's pretty good. Second one here, go through. Oh, I forgot the little red wire. Darn it. We'll have to go back and do that. Actually, I think it'll be easier to do that once I have everything soldered on. Oh my God. This little nut. This little nut's gonna give me trouble. Come on, little nut. Come here. Come here. I really wish I had a Nintendo cabinet. I could just throw this in right now. Like a known working Nintendo cabinet. That would be awesome. Because I'm going to get done with this video and I'm going to be like, okay, I have nowhere to put this monitor. I'm going to get all angsty. Cry myself to sleep. Where is there to put that Sanyo 20EZ? But I don't. Well, I'll get a power supply for Double Dragon. We'll throw it in that to test it. Okay, and then red goes up there. And I believe we said yellow was left, right? Yellow, left, black, right, right. Was that right? I suppose we can go look at some pictures. Jeff, do you have a picture? Jeff F. from Johnson City, New York. Do you have a picture? Where I can see the hot, or at least the wiring for the hot. Come on, Jeff F. You gotta have a random picture of it in there. Oh, it's not looking good. It's the backside of the hot. D689. Was that a hot he replaced? Or mine? Mine are 2D something, blah, blah, blah. Okay. I don't believe we got any picture of the way. Ah. What's that, Jeff? What do we got there? That's a picture of the wiring. Let's just look it up. 2SD870. 2SD870. Data sheet. Images. Why are you so small? Okay. Base will be left. Emitter will be right. Yep. Base will be left. Okay, base was yellow. Okay. So let's just clip off this old end. Get that out of there. I have a new little piece of wire. If I can actually strip it, my good strippers. I could. Why am I trying to cut the red wire? Give myself more work. Okay. Go. They have that base and emitter marked on the board, by the way. Your collector is the actual metal. That's going to be your collector, and then base and emitter is marked right on the board. So base is yellow, emitter is black. I mean, I'd really like to get a little bit more of a loop out of you. All these players are a little too clumsy for this kind of work. There we go. That worked. Let's just pull it down. There we go. That will definitely work. I like to get it more towards the middle though. There we go. Okay. Get to it right here. A little dab of cider. She's good.
The bass. All about that bass. Is done. All about that bass is done.
No. The Collector. You ever seen that movie, The Collector? The Bone Collector, or whatever it is? No, not Bone Collector. The Collector, I think it was. It was like a horror, cheap horror movie. I'm a big cheap horror movie fan, guys. So, in case you're wondering, cheap horror movies or time travel movies, movies where, you know, people are messing with time, like Primer. I've watched Primer, at least, if you guys haven't watched Primer, check it out on Netflix. It's got to still be there. I've watched Primer at least 5 times. And I still don't think I really get the whole movie. It's about these guys build a time machine and basically start killing past selves of them. And there's like, I think I read like the timeline online. There's like 7 different timelines or something going on during the movie. It's pretty crazy. Good movie. Super good movie. But, I mean, it totally messes with your head. Red wire. Red wire's in. I suppose let's get the...
Oh, I just broke that little plastic clip. Darn it.
I should have known my big clumsy hands were going to get to it. I'm just breaking off more pieces of it now. There. We're not going to go anywhere, but still. Well, I got to be breaking stuff, yo. Okay.
Hot's installed.
That wasn't that hard, just kind of annoying. Nothing's touching. Got my thermal grease. Non-conductive thermal grease. Got the new flyback installed. Everything on that's all wired up appropriately. Jeff F. from Johnson City. Thank you for all your help, buddy. Jeff F. on Clove, if you're wondering. His little picture tutorial helped me out tremendously.
Are we done with this monitor? I mean, we've got to test it, of course. But I mean, the things that I knew were wrong. have been repaired. Capacitor kit was installed. Oh, we need to do soundboard. Suppose we can do that. Yeah. Let's do the soundboard. Okay, guys. It's actually been a few days since I was working on this last. I had a few things come up. I actually had a little test run of Turtles in Time and some other games that I have set up down in my basement. And I had a bunch of guys over, and we played a bunch of video games. It was a really good time. So I kind of had to get ready for that. So, you know, I kind of put the rest of the video on hold, but I'm going to finish it up here tonight for you guys. And I'm going to try to get the soundboard recapped. And I'll do that all on video with you guys because it'll be pretty quick. And then I'm going to, I actually got, check this out, guys. Actually got a Nintendo Transformer. So this is going to, you know, I put my 120 volts in here. And then I get my 100 volts from my monitor out here. So that should give me power for the Sanyo 20EZ. So I can at least know that I've got, you know, steady power going into the monitor. And it's getting what it's supposed to be getting. So I can test it. And see if it actually works properly. So that's good. I got that off a Clove user, 87T66. That's 87T66. That guy has been around for forever. So I figured it was a pretty safe bet. He said it was working. So here's our cap kit for the audio board on the Sanyo 20EZ. And again, these are from iankellogg.com. Yeah, I mean, look at that. It's everything's nice and labeled for you. So, I mean, like you see here this paper cap or whatever the hell this was supposed to be. That's C378. If you can see it there on the board. See if it focuses on it. It's too dark. Anyways, it says C378, and we've got here C378. So we got replacements for that. He also gave us some replacement transistors, so it looks like those go right there on these rather large heat sinks. So we're going to have to take those off, desolder all that. And I don't think we need mica for that, but we'll see when we take it off if it needs it or not. I don't think it does. So let's get to soldering. Somebody's reflowed these headers. So that could possibly be a good thing. Let's get to desoldering here. And I just like starting. I like going right down the list. So I start at the top of the cap set, and I just go down. So C371, and we're just going to look on the board for C371. C371 is, where is it? 73, 78. I'm not seeing a C371 here. Oh, C371, there it is. Kind of hiding out behind it. All right, so let's see if we can't maybe zoom in a little bit so you guys can see exactly what I'm doing when I'm doing the soldering. We'll just zoom in a little bit, move down a little. Okay. Put us right about there. Maybe center that, zoom in a little bit more. Okay. All right, so C371. Where are you? Are you down here? C371 is right there. It's hiding out right in there, that little guy. So we're going to pop him out. And it's looking like it's those two pins right there. So Some of the solder on this looks a little bit older, so I'm going to hit it with a little bit of new solder first. That just, you know, when you got some older solder, you throw a little bit of new solder on it, makes getting it off a lot easier. You know, sometimes that solder just likes to crust on there. See, I keep looking at the camera, so now I lost my spot. I think it's that one. Well, let's put a little solder on there anyway. We'll find out later. Come on. Oh, my soldering iron is, there we go. Big old ball of solder. Let's make sure I got the right ones. I did. Okay. So here you guys can see how the solder sucker works. Oops. It's kind of getting here. Pops right out. Getting here. Pops right out. That. Perfect. That actually looks like it's slide out pretty easily. Yep, it's already fallen out. Should make sure I got polarity. Oh, it's an MP. Okay, so non-polarity, so it doesn't matter. Okay, so there you've got a view of where the new capacitor has to go. And oh, I didn't check anything. So this is 4.7 microfarad, 50 volt. And the old one looks like it is 4.7 microfarad, 25 volt. So you can always go up in voltage. You don't really want to go down, but you can always go up. And most of the time, if you don't get a cap that's, you know, the same voltage, they're usually going to increase it. Every cap kit I've ever done, they've always gone higher voltages on nearly all the caps. Well, it's not something you really need to worry about. There we go, so you can kind of see. Yeah, sure. Why not? And let's get some solder unrolled. My solder spool is running out, so I definitely need to get... I thought I had that held better. I gotta get some new solder. We did a playthrough of Turtles in Time. Me and a bunch of buddies. We had four players at a time playing. And I gotta tell you guys, that was awesome. That brought a lot of childhood back right there. And it was just a really good time. And I realized how easily that game will destroy your hands. It's just constant button mashing. And those look pretty good. I should probably not try to hold it up to the camera when I'm zooming, so I won't. And just because that's an MP cap, I'm just going to show you guys. You're clipping it a little bit above. Right above the solder point. You don't want to leave too much, but you don't want to take off too much. So you see there. There's our new cap. So that was 371. Now we're going to do 372. And let's see. 372 is, that's TR372. We should probably not pull that out. TR-373. Okay, 372 is this big guy right over here. Well, kind of fat guy. So it's those two solder points right there. Let's see. Can you see them? Those two? Oh, you can't see them. Right there. Those two. Okay. And now I forget. You know what? I'm going to zoom out a little bit. It's kind of hard to do zoomed in. There we go. I can get an idea what I'm doing. Okay, those two. We're going to try it without putting new solder on, just see how it goes. Not quite as easy. God, keep pressing the button. Let's give it another shot. Oh, there we go. That came off nicely, actually. Ooh. Oh, that's just solder. I thought the trace was lifted on that. But it was not. It's just, wow, where's the solder coming from? I just cleaned this thing out. Okay, a negative is labeled on the board. We got 4.7 microfarad, 160 volts. And here we've got 4.7 microfarad, 250 volts. Oh, this one is good. And we're just going to go through and we're going to take a little extra bit of paper off there. We're going to put the negative side where the negative side is supposed to go, and the positive side where the positive side is supposed to go. Let's bend the leg up here so we can get it nice and flush. So what I did is I bent one leg out so I can solder it. And then I'll come through and I'll solder the leg that I didn't bend. Get a little more. Well, we solder the leg that we didn't bend, then we'll bend the leg that we did bend back, just so in the future, if we're ever pulling this capacitor out, it just makes it a little bit easier. You know, you bend the leg just to kind of get the capacitor to hold on the board while you put some solder on it. Let's double check it here. And that looks good. Okay. Now we're on to 373. Let's grab our board. Look for 373. 373 is this guy up in the corner here. That's that one right there. Boy, this is leaving a little bit of solder on the board. No way. See if this thing's plugged up, maybe. Okay. Try that again. There we go. Bit cleaner. God. Boy, I cannot work tonight. Oh yeah. Very good. Okay. So here we've got 100 microfarad, 25 volt. 373, 100 microfarad, 50 volt. See, again, we went up 25 volts, and that's A-okay. Perfectly fine. Just got to make sure we get our polarity correct when we put it in. And we do. I'm just going to bend a leg so she kind of stays. Drop the cap to our solder, which is fine because the solder is basically this. Okay. Look at that. There's like barely any solder left. Definitely got to order some solder. Run out.
run out mid-project. That'd be terrible. Terrible. Absolutely terrible. Okay. There's one leg. That looks pretty good. This other cap on there. Very good. Let's give you a little bit more solder. Very nice.
Looks good. 373 is good. Now we got 374. And 374 is right there. Dead center of the board. And we got to look at this one a little bit closer because it looks like there's some stuff that's soldered right next to it. And okay. It's those two right there. So I'll get the one that's confusing me a little bit first, so don't screw that up. Okay, 374 out. 4.7 microfarad, 160 volt. Be falling everywhere. 374. 4.7 microfarad, 250 volt. Okay, stick it in. Get the polarity correct when you stick it in. You're just gonna hold it. Gonna hold it there like that. And then just bend a leg over. And that'll get the capacitor to stick there. Get a little solder. Trying to solder with the desoldering iron. And get around there, nice and tight. Bend that bad boy back. A little bit more solder. Looking good. 374 is in, and we'll just take another look. Oh god, that's crooked. That's terrible. I hate crooked capacitors. That just didn't hold in there very tight. Oh, there we go. Oh, that's much better. Thing of beauty. Much better. And what I did there, sorry guys, I did that off camera, but I just held it in with one finger and then went around the other side and hit each leg so I could just kind of get them flush with the board. They'll still work fine if it's not flush. I prefer it when they look flush, even if I know that I'm going to end up bending them up, you know, moving the board around and whatnot. Okay, so C375. C375. There's 374. C375. It's this little one right over here. Right there. Okay, well, let's kind of flip it around so I can take a look. See where it is on the board. Okay. Okay, let's get in here. That is, solder's actually coming off really nicely. This leg, though, is bent. This leg's got a nasty bend to it. And this is what I'm talking about when I say it, you know, it makes it harder to get them out. Because that leg's got a real wicked bend to it. It's just gonna, it makes it a little bit harder to get it out of there. There we go. Okay. 10 microfarad, 50 volts. Let's get our polarity right.
stick her in. Get her in there nice and tight. Bend a leg to hold her in place. Side of the other leg. And these are not staying in there very well, so I'll have to come back. I need to get this out of my way a little bit. It's another one I'll come back and clean it up after I get both legs soldered. Just kind of straighten them out. Get them a little bit more flush. That looks good. There's old flux all over this board. It's kind of crazy. A lot of old flux. That's fine. Whoever worked on it before me liked flux. It's perfectly okay. Flux is good. That's actually pretty good. We're going to leave that. We'll leave that one. We'll call that one good. 377. 377 is this big guy up here. That one. One that somebody's already replaced, it looks like. As they marked it for themselves. So they knew they didn't screw it up when they installed it. And I'm not doing this because I'm going to, you know, I don't know that I'll use this soundboard. I mean, I will eventually, once I get a Nintendo machine to put it in, you know, if I can find one that's, you know, missing pieces and somebody wants to sell cheap. It will get used. 22 microfarad, 160 volts. Whoa! Oh, I dropped my capacitors. Okay. 22 microfarad, 250 volts. So yeah, Sanyo 20EZ, I'm just gonna, you know, I'm kinda holding out for when I can find a Nintendo cabinet to put this in. Or, you know, maybe I'll use it in something else, or maybe I'll go throw it in that Double Dragon that's converted. There's my solder. You know, who knows? I don't really know what I'm going to do with it yet. We're going to kind of see what the future holds for this monitor. It's got a lot of burn-in, though, and I'm kind of having difficulty figuring out, you know, what... Wait, what am I doing here? There we go. What game the burn-in's from. Because if it's, you know, if you have burn-in on a game that you have, I mean, it's going to annoy you less, I think. I mean, yeah, when it's not showing the screen that's burnt in, you might not be so annoyed, or not be very annoyed. But, you throw it in a game that it really has no relation to, and you might get a little annoyed with that. I don't know, maybe. We'll see. I remember when I was a kid in the arcades, there was always burn-in in all the games. It never really bothered me. Like, oh, this is just an old monitor. That's what happens with old monitors. You know, when I was a kid. So, I don't know, I just wanted to play the games. I didn't really care. You know, and they're CRTs. You know, they're 30-some years old. They've been around for a while. They're not brand new by any means. Okay. 77's installed correctly. 378's weird. It's this one. And I didn't know that was a capacitor. It's really kind of funky looking to me. I'm going to rip it off here and let's see what we got. Yeah, I'm going to have to add solder to that. That one kind of came off. Let's try it one more time just for stuff, giggles, you know what I'm trying to say. Try not to cuss as much as I normally do in regular life on my channel. And I desoldered the wrong one. Okay. Well, let's fix that quick. I took the leg off the wrong thing here. That's okay. Boy. Where's that wire? There it is. This fell out. Look at this thing. What is this? Was this a capacitor at one time? At one point in its life? It looks like it. That thing blew up. Okay, 378. Let's put you in for the blown up capacitor. I have no reading on that old one, so I'm just going to assume you're right. That's about all you can do. Okay, 378. New one fits like it belongs there. So that's a good sign. Solder. That looks good. Except let's cook it. Now we're on to TR373, which is this guy down here, and this is TR374. So we've got to replace both of these, which means we've got to take the solder. You know what? And what I'm gonna do first is I'm gonna go mark my capacitors, make sure that they're on the board correctly. Okay, that one's good. That one's NP, so nobody cares about it. That one's good. 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 Okay, all our capacitors are installed correctly. So we've got that going for us. And now we're just going to clip the wires on everything. Clipping wires. This is the most exciting part about doing the a cap kit, is clipping leads. Never gets old. I'm joking. By the way, you knew that. You're aware. Oh, I cut that one really long. You look. Looks pretty good. Pretty good. Exception of that. That one's kind of long. Okay. That should definitely looks good. Now. We've got to get these transistors out. I think the easiest way to do it is just start by taking the whole heat sink off. Let's start there. You're not going to come off easily, are you? You're a gigantic blob. Oh, I don't have much solder. I understand why I got to waste it on you.
I'm going to assume I could do this without pulling these off, but I think it's going to make the job a lot easier. Boy, that's a lot of solder on there. We might need to bust out the other solder sucker here. This one might be a little bit much for my El Cheapo solder sucker. Let's try that again. Yeah, got a lot of it out. Let's see, I think the other one's up here. Yeah, it's right there. Do we need new solder on there? Nope, that's flown. Maybe not. It was flowing, just pretty unevenly. There we go. Got a lot of solder out of that bad boy. Well, now we'll just take off the actual transistor legs. It's like hair or something in here. What is keeping us in here? Is it just like that little clump of solder there? Exactly what was keeping us in there. Clump of solder. All right, let's see if we can. Come on. There we go. Okay. Here. All right, let's zoom out a little bit here. You guys get a better view of what I'm doing. And I'll show you what we got. Hey, we got that mounted on the heat plate. We got the same guy right there. So, pull it off. Throw some thermal grease on it. Probably easier to mount it back to it after I get the plate on. Get the plate back on first, I'm guessing. I think it would be. Maybe go do the other side. Yeah, I think that's what we're going to do. We're going to do the other side. And then we can take... No, there's no mic on there. Maybe take a little alcohol and clean that up. Oh, okay, so it's okay. Mounted like that. So, collector base emitter. Okay. Yeah, we're going to do the other side first. That's going to make things way easier. So what we'll do is we'll come through, we'll do this side so we can just unscrew it and pull just the transistor out. We don't have to take the heat plate out. And that'll make our life a lot easier for the install. Okay. Base collector emitter. Okay. Where are these? Vasis. 1, 2, 3 triangle right there, and that one is bridged. Okay. They're coming off, right? Yeah, okay. I'll buy a little cider to you. I'll get these other ones cleaned up really well. Not a ton of solder, just enough so you'll flow a little easier. Come on, baby. Much better. All right, perfect. It came off really well. Okay, so 374 is what we're doing first. Let's get 374 out. And the middle leg needs to get bent backwards. I really don't believe they'd switch configurations on me. And I need my little handy dandy tool here. It's going to come through. I'll bend the back one out a little bit where it needs to go. Then bend it straight. Just so we can try to match up with the holes that are in there. And as we get it situated, you guys will see. It'll go in a little bit easier with it set up like that. Yeah, I'll show you. Just kind of bend the legs so it looks similar to the one that's going in, or that you took out, rather. And that'll just, that'll help it kind of slide in. And I only do the middle leg. Once you do the middle leg, it'll slide in pretty well for you. It'll make things pretty easy. And we're just gonna take a little bit of our non-conductive thermal grease. Stick that on there. That's too much and it's goopy. But, oh well. That's what we got pants for. Okay, so TR-374. And we'll get two legs in. Push that other leg back in a little further. Unless we're going to push it down to where the screw sits. And I'm just going to go ahead and screw it right back in. Yep, I'll screw it back in easily enough. So at least I know that's where it's supposed to be. I'll take my legs on the bottom here, kind of bend them straight. Again, just so if I ever need to take them out, it'll be easier to do. Which it will be, if you do need to take them out. Because legs are straight now. All right, let's solder this bad boy on. Start over here. Get you. Good. Do this one. Do you. Good. And this bad boy right here was bridged. So I gotta make sure. I get enough solder on there to get that bridged again. Which I do. Can you see it there? Right there. That's a new install. Looks pretty good. I'm just gonna clip these right now because that looks like it is installed just fine. I should make sure it's 374, 373 is still in there. So we're good. We're good. Don't you guys worry. Looks good. Now, I think the way that went, we should install this plate first on the other one. Put the plate back in, mount the transistor to the plate, make things real easy like on us. If I just set it there, yeah, that'll work. I don't know what that was. A little piece of dirt or something. Can you see this at all? No, not really. I'm trying to get my stupid hands out of the way. Try to get that mounting plate nice and secure on there.
There we go. Looks pretty good. Yeah. Yeah, it ain't going nowhere. Okay, we got our little screw. Take our 373. Just gonna pull that one leg out, that back leg out a little bit, just a touch. Then we're just gonna give a little bend in there.
So it should make things lining up a little bit easier. Stick a little thermal grease on it. I gotta find a better form of delivery of this thermal grease. Gotta get a better, like, just a tube of it or some damn thing. This stuff's shitty. Anyways. Okay, let's get you in there. Just gotta push that leg out a little bit. Good. Just like that. Push her down. And push her against that little plate. Get her screw. Screw started. And she's in there. Oh, I almost dropped the whole damn thing. I wonder if this would be easier if I just had a little bit or something, you know, just. It's kind of wedged. Tried starting it by hand. Maybe I should do that again. See if it'll take. No, it ain't gonna take that way. Can't really start it by hand. Need just like a really small bit. You can try to get that in there easier. Alright, let's see if I can go find a really, really small Phillips bit here quick. Actually, wait. Let's see if this might work. Bite properly. It's at an angle. I can see that just the way it's screwed in there. All right, let's see what we got around here. Let's make work with that. Just a really small bit. I think I found something, guys. Oh no, it's in there. It's wedged too hard. There you go. Come on out.
much smoother, but it's not, it's not very easy to do. It's started correctly. I know what's going on straight. I'm just going to try to... And next time, remind me to just take... and screw the thing out of the heat plate while it's in there. While I have it off. Makes this job a lot easier.
Like you need a,
like an L.
I'm almost positive I don't have one handy.
Let's try this little screwdriver and see if it maybe reach in there better. All the bits on this thing are really fine though. Man! You're not making this easy on me. There we go. She's in pretty dang good. I think I get her soldered in. It'll be fine. Okay, so that's a lesson learned. Screw it onto the plate. And just solder the whole kit and caboodle in at once. Now we know. Now I know. You guys probably knew. You probably were laughing at me as I was putting that plate back on. I'm going, you shouldn't do that. You're just making things harder on yourself. Well, you know what? I did. That's okay. That's how you learn. Always got to be learning. Always got to be learning. There we go. Soundboard. Done. Looks good. I'm gonna trim up that bad boy quick. Yep. Done. I would say that's done. We replaced everything that came with the kit. So we've done soundboard, inverter board, main board, B+. Flyback, hot, all been replaced. We basically went through and replaced everything that should go wrong with one of these monitors when somebody puts the incorrect voltage to it. So, I'm gonna clean up my work area here a little bit. We'll zoom out, we'll put the monitor back together, and then see where we're at.
All right, guys, so here's what we got. Got our cases back together. First thing we're gonna do, or we've got our Sanyo here, and we're gonna get the cases in there. Anyways, first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna discharge the monitor. You always want to at least discharge it once, and we got nothing, so that's good. Then we're going to take our little, I don't know why I put my screwdriver away. We're going to take our little metal bracket that protects the neck, or the neck off here. That's where we need to hook it back up. Got that. Sorry about the mic cutting out there, guys. I ran out of space on my memory card for the microphone, so you guys are gonna end up getting some plain old camcorder audio, which isn't very good. I apologize about that. I need to get a new memory card for it. For the camera, or for the microphone, it's only got like a 2 gig. I just used what came with it for a little while. I don't know why I didn't put a new one in. It was kind of dumb. I probably should have. Let's put the soundboard in first, just so I can have that in there. Where do they do it? There it is. I'm working on it. It went in like that. Okay. Went in like that. Because that went right there. I know that much. I should see if I can find some screws to put in this thing. Like, there should be a screw right there, I think. Well. And then this little plug goes over here. Right on there. It just goes out to there. Okay. All right, so I think the easiest way to put this back in there is to, I think I slid it out through this side. Yeah, I did. Let's just slide it right back through. And then, I don't know about that neck board. We'll see. We'll see where you end up. Get you guys out of the way right now. My power cord through. You guys can see all this? Yeah, you're good. You can see all of it. I think this is just going to come right through here, like so. Then you go down there. Let's just get you guys out of the way for right now. I think you go down here. Yeah, you do. I can only go in one way. that should stay down there. Pictures of this, make sure I'm hooking everything up properly. We'll get there. A piece of paper, get that out of there. Okay, do you go like that? That looks right. There for you to sit in, okay, and then you go like that. You go like that. And should be able to just push everything right back on. Okay. That seems awfully tight to me. Why does that feel so tight? Gentle, like, just kind of wiggling back and forth. That looks good. Okay. Oh, this worries me now, because that could go over there too. And then where are you? Main power for the board? Where do you go then? Come on, squeaky chair, ease up on me, man. Oh, let's mount everything. Let's just get everything mounted and then we'll kind of see where things sit. Okay. I need to put at least one screw there. Trying to see if there's anything I need to plug in the neck board. I don't see anything. You know what? I'm gonna hold off. I was gonna put the cover on there, but I'm gonna wait to do that. We'll wait to do that. You know what I mean? Oh, I'm really curious. Where you are going. Can you reach over here? Could you go over here? You absolutely could.
Okay, so you can reach there, you can't, so you gotta go here. I think this is starting to click. Yeah, I think that's starting to click. JC. JB. JB. Ooh. Ooh, we almost hooked something up wrong. Okay. So that's JB. So what are you? You're JC. So JC goes here. Okay. That was good. We avoided some kind of catastrophe there, boys. I need a flashlight. Don't worry, I got one right here. So I see, boy, it's not a good angle to see you at AD. That's for the inverter board. I mean, you gotta go there, right? What does that go to? That goes into my degauss coil, I believe. I just wanna see if there's something. You can go down there. Nope, you can't go down there. I lied. Oh, and I remember that was blank. I saw jumpers on somebody else's online, but mine was blank. I think that's where you have to go. Yeah, that is how that goes. That makes sense. But what? Oops, what do we got? Okay, that goes into our inverter. Oh, you go on the neck board. I remember that much. Okay. There's that. Okay, so you've got to go like that. Because that's the only way you'll really go in there. Yep. Okay, that's in. that's in. This goes to my inverter. That's power to my soundboard. Nope. Okay. Good to know. That won't fit. Figure out how exactly this was supposed to be mounted, because it was not even mounted, it was just hanging out in my cab before. So is it like that? It kind of slides behind. Stuck on here. I think it should go like that, but I need to get seem to want to go over any further. That plate's there. Bend that out a little bit. See the problem here. So this won't go out any further with that in there like that. So I'm just going to pull it out of here. The little remote board here. Because we kind of just stuck it in there after we replaced it. But I think I can put it right there like that. It's not going to really affect anything.
go. There we go, that'll work. I gotta find some screws. I gotta find some screws that'll fit in there. This one's from another part of the board, but I think it'd be nice if I could get that to be secure on there. There we go. Yeah, that's a lot better. So at least I have one screw in there. Do our... Ooh, that scared me. Solid. Just gonna, you know what, we'll put you through here. Okay. And this is our power. This can go to going to be our input. I think it is, isn't it? Can't be because it didn't fit. Where's another one coming from? Oh, okay. So that's our input. And that should be coming from well, we'll try it like this and see how it ends up. Clip this wire in here too. Say not inverted now. Transformers to the soundboard, so I'm just going to put you out to the side for right now. I think that's it, guys. Oh, shoot. To reattach my ground. That might not be the right screw for it. It looks too big. This one's smaller. That one here? I think I did.
I think I did. I did. Okay, so I do need that one. Look like standard PC case sizes. I wonder, where is my, I've got like a bucket of screws sitting around here. Not a bucket, but like a little bin full of PC screws for like computers. Where is that? Hold on, guys. Just hold on for one sec. Where is it? There it is. I mean, not ideal, but they might work. Let's give it a shot. I don't know if the threading is the same or it shouldn't look like it. Nope. That didn't go. Let's try one of the smaller ones. Like, maybe that one. That's not going either. Shoot. I don't know where this big one comes from. That don't fit in there. No way. I gotta find out where that one goes. You know what? At the very least, before I do any damage, let's get that cover back on. Oh, sorry guys, this is gonna end up being a super long video, but I'll try to cut out some parts, speed some parts up, maybe save you guys a little bit of torment. Okay. All right. I think that about does it, guys. That's in there nice and solid. The ground is solid. Oh, this is the one they tied in a knot. That's right. I should do that. We'll do that. We'll just put a little knot around it. I don't know why, but Nintendo soft fit to do it, we might as well too. We'll just be gentle about it. Real gentle. Okay. Well, I think I'm going to try to find some screws for this. See if we can find something to fit in there so I can secure that plate that, you know, that the inverter board sits on, because before that was just hanging loose. But I think that should just about do it for this video.
Unfortunately, I don't have that transformer wired yet, so I can't give you guys a display of it working, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to wire up that transformer, find some screws, and see if I can find something to test that on. I don't know if it'll work on my Turtles in Time or not. Suppose I could try. I don't know. I'll go look. We'll find out. But, God, it's going to drive me nuts. Yeah, I think we're going to call this video good for right now. So there's your Sanyo 20EZ rebuild. Who knows if it worked? We're going to find out soon. But thank you guys for watching. I really appreciate it. If you like the video, give me a thumbs up. You know, subscribe if you could. I would really appreciate it if you subscribed. I'm going to keep coming out with videos. Stuff like this, rebuilds. And, you know, hopefully the quality will keep getting better for you. So I'm going to call it, and I'll get this uploaded in the next couple days. Thanks, guys.